Good morning, or good afternoon, depending on where you are. My name is João Soares. I am from Polytechnic of Porto, in Portugal. I am a co-author of this paper, Learning Bidding Strategies in Local Electricity Markets Using End Colony Optimization. Sorry. This paper is in a poster session, so this is the outline of this short presentation. Policymakers around the world and in Europe have been concerned with climate change for some years now. New policies have been put in place to achieve a successful transition to green energy. The increase of renewable energy has been steady in the last few years, and consumers' involvement can be important to improve the use of renewables and achieve the maximum possible production. In this context, local markets may emerge as a solution to leverage the consumers' empowerment so they can participate as real actors in the energy system. The problem is that local markets are not a trivial, are not expected to be trivial to be implemented. There are some technologies around this topic that are being explored, like blockchain proposals, peer-to-peer proposals, and also artificial intelligence can play a significant role to achieve this implementation and this transition. So, in our research paper, we propose a model. It is an optimization model in which we have agreed. We have the existence of traditional retailing markets, and we have local electricity markets. So we have agents that are consumers, agents that are producers and consumers, and agents that are only producers. And these agents will try to maximize their profits and minimize their costs by trading in the local electricity market. So we have in the upper level, since this is a level optimization, we have upper level problem maximization of these agents' profits, and in the lower level we want to maximize the energy transacted at the local level in the local electricity market. So a clearing price mechanism happens in this lower level problem. So this is the mathematical formulation. This is explained in detail in the paper. So we have one term that is the producer profits in the upper level problem, and another term that is the consumer costs. So we want to maximize these two terms. And this upper level problem depends on the lower level because of the clearing price. This is noted as CP. And as I said before, so lower level is to obtain the clearing price that depends on the bids and offers on these agents. And when these offers and bids are allocated using merit order based on price, we have the supply curve, demand curve, and then the interception of these curves is the clearing price. So this clearing price, CP, is then supplied to the upper level problem, and then we are able to compute the profits costs for all agents. To solve this optimization problem, this V-level problem, we adopt an artificial intelligence technique, the end colony optimization. So this takes inspiration from the behavior seen in ants. It's not exactly new, this algorithm. The ants deposit pheromone on the ground to mark some favorable routes, paths to the food, and they are reinforced since when new ants try to follow this route. So this is more or less the inspiration on the way that ants behave in real world in the nature. We implement a distributed ICO in which each agent has their own pheromone matrix, and we reinforce this matrix as a function of the fitness, which is the agent profit or agent cost, depending on the type of agent. And we also have a measurement of the fitness of all the system that in which the fitness of all the system is average profits of all agents, agents and costs, and the deviation between how much agent one or agent two differs in this in their profits. So a standard deviation. So in order to test our methodology that is fully described in the paper, we have in the case study we have a study of 9 agents, 3 consumers, 3 generators, and 3 prosumers. The parameters of this optimization model are described in this slide. We have the demand for different types of houses and the demand for PV. We have a time horizon of 24 periods, and we have some price for the feed-in and grid tariffs and the characteristics of the cogeneration CHP unit. So all of these are inputs to the problem. So in order to achieve the best values or using the end column optimization, we perform a tuning of parameters, so the evaporation rate, the rho, alpha and beta of ACO have been tested in the first experiment. We observed that lower values usually provide better results, and then we fixed the evaporation rate as 0.3, alpha 0.5, and beta 0.5, and then we played with the M, the parameter, and the iterations. So we played with the number of ants and the number of iterations as a stopping criteria. So more iteration and more ants improved the quality of the solution, and our recommendation was 20 and 40 for the number of ants and around 501,000 for the number of iterations. We also compared ACO with another algorithm, Bartle search algorithm. And for this comparison, we run the algorithms for 30 runs, 30 trials, and we observe the costs of the system and also the execution time. This vertex search algorithm was previously developed and published in last December in ISAP conference. We can observe that ACO compared with the vertex is better. And also the execution time is not is worse, but it's not very different from the results that we published in last December. Compared without local market, the difference is now even more pronounced than the last published results. Here we show some performance assessments. Namely, how is the convergence rate and average convergence of ACO, and also the best solution we found using 1000 fitness evaluations. So consumers can reduce their costs and also producers can obtain more profits. This is more graphics that show the learning behavior of independent of the each agent. Using the distributed ICO, so the group of consumers, prosumers, and producers is interesting to see how they perform. So to conclude, this is ongoing work. We started to publish in ISAP the paper with vertex search. Now we improved the work, and we use the end column optimization. The results have improved. And our future work is to search for independent definition of ACO parameters for each agent and other advanced versions like using distributed computing platform and more realistic scenarios. So thank you so much.